Yo, what's up? It's Yo Remy and I'm back. So in this video, I'm gonna talk to you about how I built a personal chatbot for myself. Yes, I built a Yo Remy chatbot and how I've leveraged this chatbot to scale my reach and build my brand. As you probably noticed from the past videos, I'm not just a serial entrepreneur, I am a maker. So I love building things and taking my ideas to MVP, to launching them, to getting feedback and turning them into revenue generating startups. Or if I understand it's not something people do not want and they're, if I'm gonna charge, willing to pay for, simply shut it down. Also something that I would say, and this is more recently, which really is something that I enjoy, is actually documenting the process, sharing as much as I can about the process of going from idea to revenue generating startups. So through doing this, the best way to do it is obviously through content. One of the recent builds that I did is our chatbot, which I'll link down here to the previous video I did on our chatbot. But I built our chatbot in the open and really just kind of let everyone follow along. The feedback I got from it was amazing. People loved seeing me take an idea to chatbot to literally generating thousands of messages via this chatbot and eventually turning this into something more than just an idea, an initial kind of MVP. So after I did this build, I also really became convinced in the power of chatbots. You know, with chatbots, I immediately saw how I could kind of leverage this conversational design that chatbots have with other concepts. And so I knew that I needed to then build another chatbot. Now, I was kind of thinking, you know, what should I build? And I didn't really just want to build another standalone product that didn't kind of benefit everything I was already doing. And I'd also think, you know, thought about my personal kind of all the content that I put out and my personal brand. And then I just realized that, how beneficial it would be for me to build a Yo Remy chatbot. Now, one of the first reasons why I thought this would be beneficial is because it's basically social platforms consolidated into one. So everyone's like, hey, be omnipresent across all social platforms and get your content, you know, repurposed across everything. And I was just thinking like, that's a lot to keep up with. Of course, I try to be omnipresent, but I really want one kind of one place to send one message and this, you know, the highest quality message I could and just make it easier for people to not have to like follow me on everything. So I thought Facebook Messenger would be the perfect place to do this because I can kind of package up all the channels and all the content into this chatbot. This would be ultimately the kind of centralized place where I would want to push people to. All right, now the other is that I thought was the ability to control the narrative. So that's something when, you know, you have content across all the channels, it can kind of become fragmented and then the message can also become fragmented. So having this one channel would allow me to control what I wanted to tell people in that narrative and then ultimately how it's received, which of course is very beneficial when you're trying to get something out to people and then people at scale. The other that I was thinking about, which is a big benefit of having a personal chatbot, is people spend all their time on Facebook. Like, let's admit, you and I both spend a ton of time on Facebook, and when you get that message, someone messages you through Facebook and you hear that ding, you're gonna look at your phone most likely. It will at least probably over an email or a text message. I know I do personally. So I just thought, wow, I mean, what better way to reach people than where they spend all their time? Just Facebook Messenger, and which is where the chatbot would be accessible to people. Now that I kind of thought about the benefits of it, I was totally convinced, all right, I just need to build this chatbot. The process that I used to build my Yo Remy chatbot was fairly straightforward, and it kind of follows a lot of the other process for my other side projects. But I first thought about why I was building this and how this would be valuable for people and try to define that and come up with this kind of chatbot. And it was really, first off, just identifying the goal of just making a place where people can learn more about me, consume my content, and contact me regarding projects or, you know, helping them out if they have any questions about this. When I kind of had that down, then I needed to kind of go into, okay, all these channels that I just mentioned, for instance, all these Medium articles, how do I then include those? Because they're already out there. They're already something that I get a ton of really good feedback on, even these YouTube videos. So how do I then package them in my chatbot? Because that's the best way you know, to let people consume this content and feature it in there. So what I came up with was actually a YoRumi playbook. So I thought, you know, what does all the content cover? And it's literally about going from an idea to MVP to revenue generating startup to scale, and even some acquisitions that I've had in the past. So what better way to kind of package this up and make it easy for people to navigate than having a YoRumi playbook in my chatbot? So that's actually what I did. So I repurposed a lot of the Medium articles in sequence in a playbook, and also these videos in the chatbot. I'll screenshot here for the actual dashboard for ChatFuel. So I did use ChatFuel, and I actually took the our chatbot template and I repurposed it. So I simply duplicated that to create the YoRumi bot. And then I simply modified using the blocks, the content that would be there. So I'll screenshot here. You can see the ChatFuel dashboard, and it's actually my playbook. And then it's the about me, ask a question, and then it's contact me, or and then after that is the actual kind of share. So there's a little virality effect in there. So people could then message their other friends through Messenger and share it. So that's the kind of basic template that I used in ChatFuel. So it's very straightforward. So this took less than an hour. Honestly, what it came down to was just getting all the existing content that I had already put out, kind of packaging it up through this chatbot, you know, just modifying the templates, and then kind of testing that conversational interface and design, and just modifying it so I can make it kind of as natural and smooth as possible based off of what people actually want to see and would be interested in. After about an hour, maybe an hour at most, I actually had this YoRumi chatbot live. What I did from there was I actually responded to some emails that I got from people asking me questions, and I pointed them towards the link for the chatbot. And you know, just I said, hey, I'm building this chatbot, and I'm because I get a lot of questions that are similar to yours. Here's a direct answer to your question, but I would love if you could give me some feedback on this chatbot that I just made live, literally like 30 minutes ago. So I did that, and you know, people were very receptive to that. It was only like 5 or 6 at first, but I got some really good feedback. So I made some improvements on that conversational flow, and that was great. So it's like my first kind of user feedback. And then from there, I followed a typical kind of launch framework that I take for products, because this was, and it is, a kind of a product. It's just my chatbot for myself, featuring my content packaged up as a playbook. But I then went to Botlist, which I know I've mentioned Seth, the founder of Botlist. He's amazing when it comes down to chatbots. He knows everything. Well, his website, Botlist, is a great place to take your chatbot and get your first users. So I posted on YoRumi bot on Botlist, which I'll screenshot the profile here, but it got around 4,000 initial views. So I would say maybe a couple hundred users from that to people that actually tried it out. It got a few people to review it. So it's kind of like an app store for chatbots. So it was a perfect place for me to launch. From there, I've actually taken created a bit.ly short link. So I have a bit.ly/YoRumi, and that's actually my chatbot link. So now, instead of just having my website and all my content everywhere, I can actually link directly to my chatbot. And the benefit of that is, people can obviously consume that content and you know, find my playbook through there. But then when people use the chatbot, they can contact me, but they're also kind of a subscribed user. So then when I come out with new content, I can actually push them a message, and they'll be the first to know through my chatbot about this new content that I have coming out. So I actually want to go into another video talking about now, after I've launched the chatbot, how effective chatbots can be for sending messages versus sending emails, but I'm going to keep this video short. You can expect another video coming up soon talking about that and results, but so far I've had some amazing feedback on it, and it seems to be actually adding value to people that do have questions and are interested in taking their idea to an MVP, to live, to revenue generating startup. So why don't you check it out? I'll link down here below the chatbot, but comment below, let me know what you think, give me some real honest feedback on it, and I definitely want to improve, and hit subscribe so I keep making these videos. See ya.